Welcome to my channel. If you like my videos, then kindly subscribe, like and watch. Thank you.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Welcome back. Problem 7.7. So this is state of stress that is given. So again, you have to find the principal plane and principal stresses. So given data, we have sigma x, which is in this direction. This sigma x is 150 megapascal. Similarly, sigma y, you can see this sigma y is 30 megapascal. Clear? And tau of x y, which is negative, and this is minus 80 megapascal. Why it is negative? So again, I will explain that this is the plane and this is perpendicular to the axis in positive direction. Clear? And now one is this, and again you can see this is the shear stress, which is in acting on this plane, x plane, and it is in negative y direction. So this top xy is minus 80. The value of this shear stress is 80, and so the shear stress is minus 80 megapascal. So the second is to what you have to find. Again, you have to find part A is principal plane, clear, which is theta p1 and theta p2, and the principal stresses, that is maximum and minimum stresses. So let's start with the solution. This is the same thing. So for part A, we know that tangent of, or finding theta p, so we know that tangent of 2 theta p is equal to 2 tau of xy divided by sigma x minus sigma y. So 2 tau is minus 80, clear, divided by sigma x is 150 minus sigma y is 30. Clear? So tangent of 2 theta p will be equal to, when you solve this, so it will give you minus 1.33. Clear? So 2 theta p will be equal to tan inverse minus 1.33. So 2 theta p will be equal to 53.13 degree. Clear? So theta p can be obtained if you divide 2 on both sides. So theta p will be equal to minus 53. Clear? So when you take the tangent inverse of minus 1.3, it is minus 53.13. So theta p1 will be equal to minus 26.6 degree, and theta p2 will be equal to minus 26.6 degree plus 90 degree, and that is equal to 60. Let me correct it. 63.4 degree. Clear? So this is principal planes. Principal plane will lie at angle of minus 26.6 degree or 63.4 degree. I will show you in a while. Now we will find the B part, which is given as sigma max comma minimum is equal to sigma x plus sigma y divided by 2 plus minus under the root sigma x minus sigma y divided by 2 whole square plus tau of xy whole square. Okay, so put the value of sigma x, you can see this is 150. So 150 plus sigma y is 30 divided by 2 plus minus 150 minus 30 divided by 2 whole square plus tau of xy, which is minus 80 whole square. Clear? So this is sigma max comma minimum. Again, this is equal to 180 divided by 2, which is 90, plus minus, this will be equal to 120 divided by 2, which is 60 whole square, plus 80, minus 80 whole square, minus 80 whole square. Clear? So this sigma max comma minimum is equal to 90 plus minus the value of under root, when you take it will give you 100. So what we conclude, that sigma max is equal to 90 plus 100, which is equal to 190 megapascal, and sigma minimum is equal to 90 minus 100, which is equal to only 10 megapascal, minus 10, because it is 90 minus 100, so it is minus 10 megapascal. So these are the principal stresses. So again, if I represent them in order, so let's say this is your x-axis, this is your, sorry, x-axis, and this is your y-axis. Again, I will represent them with a different color so that you can easily pick the point. Clear? So you can see that theta p1 is minus 26 degree. So it is minus 26. So you have to take minus. So this will be your x dash, and perpendicular to this x dash will be y dash. For example, this is your y dash. So this angle is your minus 26.6 degree, or this angle is also minus 26.6. So if you want to represent them, so you have to draw the element here. So again, you can see your principal stress will be along this this x dash, which is equal to 190 megapascal, that is sigma max. There, this will be again sigma max, and your sigma y will be sigma minimum will be compressive one, because it is minus 10. So sigma minimum is equal to minus 10 mega pascal. Clear? I hope you have enjoyed the video. If you like it, kindly subscribe, like, and watch. Thank you.